Well, we are at a geek conference. So I think talking about public speaking for geeks on a geek conference, you cannot find a better place to do that. Many of you, when you were kids, have heard that if you get good marks, if you work hard, if you do not make any trouble, you will be successful in life later on. We geeks have taken it very deeply in ourselves, and we tend to sit in our basement, do our code, and never ever tell anyone about it, even if it's great, because we believe it's great, we believe that everyone should use it, but then we complain why nobody uses it, and nobody uses it because nobody have heard about this code. Unfortunately, to tell others about your project, you have to go forward to them. You can go forward to them by blogs, by posts, but you also can go forward to them on conferences. And normally, it works if you use all techniques at the same time. Well, you have probably heard others telling you that you should present your project, but there is one monster between yourself and the success of your project. That's your fear of public speaking. What I have heard is that the fear of public speaking is the second worst human fear after the fear of death. I think it may be true for quite many people. But I also know that you can work over it. You may believe me or not, but I was absolutely scared of public speaking. If you have seen me 20 years ago, I wouldn't be there. I would have been hidden somewhere instead of doing the talk. You can work with it. Currently, I'm not stressed at all while speaking to this audience. Probably it would be better if I had been a little bit. That helps. That helps you to concentrate. Unfortunately, I'm not. I can be playing with you. To help you work over your fears, what I have prepared is an algorithm how to prepare a solid presentation, how to come from I have never done a presentation to do a solid one that will not have bells and whistles, but it will be solid. It will pass your message forward. And that's the most important thing. First, very important point. Find out what you want to tell your audience. It has to be a short message you can tell in one sentence. Write it down. It's fine to write it down so you understand what it is. Then we will use this message later on in this talk. What can it be, your message? I have put a number of examples. Probably the most popular would be, I want to show that my project exists. I want to show you what it does. Another type of a talk may be, I want help, I want more developers in there. If you have a new version of your project, you want to announce the features. This means that you will concentrate on the features, on the new things that are happening. Or you have a problem. You want to ask other developers or the users what would they like to see or how to solve your problem. It's a good subject of a talk too. And a very interesting type of a subject that I do not see that often, I would like to see it more, is a return of experience. You have tried to use a technology. You have spent time on it, and you show the things that worked and the things that didn't work, and how you have solved your problems to avoid other people to run into the same problems as you did. Okay, you have your message. Then we'll plan for the structure of your talk. What I often see at geek conferences is that the talk has a very complicated structure. I'm getting lost easily. So for the scope of this talk, I have invented a project that doesn't exist, but it will work as an example. My project is I have stickers that you can attach to things, and then you have a phone app that will allow you to find those things. Okay? If someone has something that works like that, I'm interested. Now, how would I present this project on a conference? I will use a simple three-step structure. First, I will show how you attach the pins or the stickers to things. I will demonstrate it. Then I will show how you register those things in the phone app with a small demo. Then I will do the exciting part. How do we find it out? And the demo too. Three items for each item, an example, plus an introduction, plus conclusion. If you would like to start with a structure of your talk, go for a simple structure like this. You will be fine. Your audience will understand it and won't get lost. They will know how you are going to follow. They will know what your message is. Remember also your message when you are preparing the structure. Your structure needs to follow the message. So if you try to draw a structure, there are things that do not fit your message. Those are the things to leave for another talk. You can do multiple talks on one project. You don't have to put everything in a single talk. Okay, we do have a structure. People have that feature that they love stories. Stories play with our emotions and they make the audience feel and understand what you want to talk about. For my example of a project, I would use a story in the introduction. How would the story look like? A year ago, I have had a very bad day. I was already late for a meeting, but I found out that I have to take something from my home. So I had my car full of stuff. I came back home. I went out of the car. I come to the door of my house, and I cannot find my keys. It was a disaster. I knew that the keys are somewhere in the car. But I started searching around, below and around, and between the bags, I couldn't find it. That was probably the worst 10 minutes in my life until I found them. And that was the day when I decided I have to work on something, some technical solution that's going to help me with this project. Okay? If you do that kind of an introduction of a project, you have the audience. They will understand why you did it. And they will remember similar moments in their life. You had. We are geeks. We are detailed. Talks on a conference have another nice feature that they have limited time. And we would like to tell everything about what we know about our technology in 15 minutes. Well. You do not know who is on your audience. Probably the people won't know the same things about your project as you do. So if you go directly into the details, you're going to lose the audience. You are probably going to compete for the award of the shortest time you can spend to lose your audience so they leave. In fact, I have seen some presentations that made me nearly cry when people were doing stuff like introduction and then, oh, that's the cute API page. So I'm going to present the Qt API for X, Y, and Z. Now we get all the functions and we are going to go over one function and another for 30 minutes. You are going to get the award and people will start leaving 15 seconds after you start. No, that's not the most efficient way to do it. What I would recommend you to spend at least 30% of the time of your presentation to introduce your subject. You will feel, probably, that you are going to lose time on it. But in reality, you won't. Because people will need to understand what you are talking about, what do you want to tell them. At least mention the background you are going to use, so they can understand the rest of the talk. If you want to present them the whole Qt API, probably a public speaking talk is not the best idea to do that. You can do a series of blog posts for that. I do a talk presenting the things you have learned, the interesting bits that you have found in the API. That works very well. Preparation. Well, you cannot make a good talk during the night before the presentation. I'm sorry. Just writing down the ideas you have, writing down the structure you are going to have, removing unnecessary stuff, then coming back 2 days later to find out that finally I'm missing some elements that I find important, so I need to reshuffle stuff, then do the slide deck, then decide, okay, I'm missing things in the slide deck, or there's too much on one subject in the slide deck. That takes time. You will invest your time very well if you spend time preparing a presentation. It will be much easier and much more effective. Try. I've spent for this presentation, it has had 3 drafts before I started doing slides. And finally, practice. This looks hard, but it's not really that hard as you'd like to do. Before you apply for a keynote at Potsdam, you can try for smaller groups of people. What I would recommend you to try is to look in your area. If there are some Linux user groups or a specific application user groups, and then you can do a presentation for 10 or 20 people. That is much easier, much less stressful, and then you can talk with everyone what they think about the things you did, what you can improve, what you can explain more. And you are much more friendly, you can become friends with them, then it's much easier for you. Also, if you want to advance more in public speaking, if you are more serious about it, or if you are starting becoming serious about it, look for public speaking clubs in your area. I am a Toastmaster member. It's very effective. Look for a similar places in your area. Very good a solution. You are going to advance very fast. And you can watch how others do it. On a conference, you can look, when you watch a speech, what do you like in how the person is delivering their talk. what do you find effective in the way they are talking, and what doesn't work for you? So then you can get that feedback accepted in your own talk. And last but not least, there are great videos on the internet with great talks. If you haven't heard about the TED, T-E-D, take your time, but you need to reserve a big afternoon, because if you start looking into that, it is at least going to take an afternoon. But great things, great speakers, you can learn a lot by just watching how they do it. So my algorithm for you, your message. One sentence, what your message is of the talk. Then get a structure that is reflecting the message. Remove everything that is not reflecting the message. Put just the important things in the structure. Add stories that are going to make it more human, more interesting, more fun. At the beginning of your talk, take time to talk about what you are going to talk about. What do the audience has to know before you start? Prepare it in advance and practice it. If you are delivering the same talk multiple times, it's going to be different. And you are going to learn many things. There are hundreds of different subjects we can talk about public speaking, from the choice of presentation software to how many slides per minute you should have, or the problems when you are a native speaker or not, how to deal with the audience that is not happy with you, and many, many others. However, they are not the most important things out there. I would recommend you, for example, to spend time rather on the structure of a presentation than on trying to run the newest, greatest presentation software. Much more useful, retroactive of investment, much better. If you have questions, drop me a message. I may be available if you want to talk about the presentation you are doing or you are planning to do. If you want feedback, if you want to tell me to watch how you do it, what you can improve, what you can do better, or if you just want to try your first presentation, contact me. We'll see what we can do. Thank you. Do you have any questions?
Look, thank you for the talk. It was very enjoyable. It's one of the better talks that I've seen at a tech conference recently. Just looking at some of your points, you focused on the message or the objective that people have with their talk. When we were coordinating a dev room at FOSDEM this year, one of the things I was thinking about was asking our speakers to actually identify their message when they apply to give a talk. Is that way they would start thinking about it very early on? The use of pictures was good, but I noticed you didn't comment on using slides and pictures and things too much, but it's really interesting. And also, what other efforts would you like to make to help people with this topic? Like, will you give more talks at FOSDEM? Or would you like to help give people workshops to practice their skills? Or have you thought about this thing?
Well, there are really many things we can do. I guess that a talk like this one that just raises awareness is one of the things. I would like it to be... To talks like that, I would like to deliver, for example, for people who are on the technical conference for the first time. That will be useful for them when they're trying to prepare. You have mentioned workshops. That would be nice to have too. Workshops allows people to train. And I know from my experience that even a short workshop with a small number of exercises, I would say 3 or 4 hours, is going to have a tremendous effect on how the people behave as a public speaker. I've seen that. I know it works. So we can talk later on of the things that can be done. I think that we can improve the level of public speaking at geek conferences without too much effort.
Anybody else?
Nice talk, and I want to know your opinion about live demo in presentations. I saw presentations with the guy talking, suddenly it starts to live coding.
Yeah, live demos, yeah, that's one of the nicest subjects at geek conferences. What I would recommend the beginners is to record the demo on the video and then play it. If the video playing program is working, then it will work. Because otherwise they will get just too stressed and the staff will just go away, absolutely. For what I'm using personally, I do put all the commands I need in some file, or I have it in history. So that, then I do not make errors when typing in the commands. That's one of the worst things that may happen. And then you go debugging. And if the demo doesn't work, that's hard to do. But what I think you should do is just, I'm sorry, the demo didn't work, simulator on, and go forward with the presentation instead of spending 10 minutes trying to fix it.
Okay. And finally, you in one of the last slides, you said think about the language you would use. But is this a choice, a real choice? Because I think you have only two choices, or the language of the audience or the English.
It's also a very interesting question. There are different Englishes in the world. it's a joke, but it's not totally a joke. It happened to me to see on a conference in English, I guess an English person who wasn't understood because of the structures, the expressions they were using. They were too advanced for the audience to understand. Also, there's language, but there's also the speed you talk. If you talk too fast, people who struggle a little bit with English, they will have trouble understanding you. So if you are talking to English native speakers, you talk faster. If you are talking to people for whom you know they may have trouble, you should talk in a much slower way. So you also should provided time during your presentation because you are going to speak slower. There's all those language things that are to be considered for a presentation.
Anyone else? Okay, first let's give a hand to Marta, and then we will have...